Dear students, this video discusses about waveguide corners, bends and twist. So basically these are the various types of waveguide bends, corners and twist. They are used to normally change the direction. Suppose we want to change the direction of the rays, then we can use these bends can be used to change the direction of the wave. So whichever through how much ever angle we want to change, depending upon that we can use any of these waveguide bends, twist or corners to change the direction. Now in this here, A and B denotes the dimension and L is known as the mean length. That is, there is a, in order to reduce the reflections from the discontinuities of this waveguide, this L is usually selected to be equal to an odd number of quarter wavelength. So it can, and also the wavelength inside the waveguide is usually represented as lambda g. So in order to minimize, the mean length is usually selected to be equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda g by 4, where lambda g is the guided wavelength and n value will be 0, 1, 2, 2, etc. Then lambda g is the wavelength of the waveguide. So if the length is designed in such a way, all the reflected waves from both the ends of the waveguide section will be completely cancelled. Similarly, for the waveguide bend, here this is denoted as R. So if you are so there is a design value to be followed, that is the minimum radius of curvature for small reflection is given by R is equal to 1.5b for an E bend. So if you design it in such a way that the radius of curvature is equal to 1.5 into b, b is the dimension of it, so that can result in small reflection. And similarly, r equal to 1.5a for an h bend. So here a and b are dimensions of the wave.